the love her show with the duo. You gotta love her, praise her, treat her right. Let your life reflect all the beauty that's inside of you. You gotta love yourself, let the best of you shine through.
Welcome to the Love Her Show with the Duo.
Yes, welcome, welcome back. I'm Kelly Fisher.
And I'm Tana Gilmore.
And together,
we're the matchmaking duo.
Woohoo, we are back to another week of our podcast, the Love Her Show.
We have, yes. And for those of you that are just joining us, this is a podcast where we discuss all things love, life, business, and bliss.
Yes, and for those of you who are just following us for the first time, we are life and relationship coaches. We're professional matchmakers, authors, keynote speakers,
Essence.com contributors.
Yes, and we are authors,
yes,
of our critically acclaimed book, Relationship
Do-Overs.
Yay! Yes. So come on in. We're so glad to be back and back on track here to meet with you every week.
Mm-hmm. I hope you all are enjoying the podcast. We certainly appreciate the feedback that we get in our inbox. And we launched a new Love Her community called Hey Lover. Yeah. And it's L-O-V-H-E-R-S.
Yes, so, exclamation point. Mm-hmm. So we were thinking, how did we come up with that name? I think it was just like, you know, wanting to say, I guess, an extension of our podcast and people who follow us and just sometimes just wanted to check in and say, hey, lovers.
Yeah, you know what? The people want a community. They want a place where they can go and ask questions and maybe have some interaction and, you know, just connect with us. And we wanted a place to connect with you all as well. So we want to feel connected to our followers and our readers. And we just appreciate you so much. So just thank you again. And if you have not joined the Love Her community, please do it and invite a girlfriend too. So
yes,
we're going to be launching some great things in there and discussing some great things. And we pop in on video here and there when we can in between meetings and other foolishness that we have going on.
Yes, maybe we'll do one today. Maybe we'll pop in today and say hi.
As we're always going to eat something.
Oh, yeah, we're on our way to sushi in a minute. We're going to take a 30-minute, well, hey, my time is always off. So probably an 1 hour sushi break and then we'll be back at it.
Back at it to work.
Yeah, I love the name Love Her also because I think it just speaks to the fact that whether you're in a relationship or not, everybody wants to be a lover.
Yeah,
you know,
me
everyone
too.
Wants to be a lover, and we also encourage everyone to love themselves.
Love her. Mm-hmm. You know, love yourself. Definitely.
Yes, love each other. So I think the name is so fitting. So we're proud of it.
Yeah, we are. And you know what? It's so on time too, because today, you know, we are talking about, and we'll get to it in just a minute, but, you know, we're going to talk about the tweet from Leslie Jones about, and how do we support and help the Leslie Joneses of the world. So that's going to be our topic today. But, you know, first we just want to check in and see how everybody was over the weekend, how you enjoyed the game, what you guys did. How was your weekend?
Oh, my weekend was great. So Saturday I was running around, of course, taxi driving with the girls, my daughters.
Driving.
I'm a certified taxi driver on
now,
Saturday.
Don't get paid.
Don't get paid. And then spending money. So they went, they went roller skating. They went, had a sleepover. They did all kind of stuff. So I was riding all over the place. Sunday, let's see, we went to church and then I went out with one of my girlfriends and she brought her son and a few of his friends at middle school. And I brought my daughter and one of their friends, and we went to kind of like a sports bar, but it's kind of like a family type of place, and watched the game, and it was fun to get out. I hadn't realized that all these years, I think, at being a single mom, I didn't realize that, you know, we can go out and have fun, too. You know, I would be like, oh, well, I have my daughter, so if we weren't invited to something like a family event, then we wouldn't go. But we had the most amazing time, so hey, just encouraging everyone out there, if you have your children with you or you happen to be a single parent, you can go out and have fun too. Yeah, not to the bar, but to the other side, the restaurant part. And we were screaming and hollering, having a great time with the whole community. So it was fun.
I mean, it's an environment where everybody's screaming. So you don't have to be like even self-conscious about worrying, oh, my kids are too loud or you know, they may be acting up. Everybody's acting up. It's an environment that everybody's screaming. Everybody's having a great time. So
many adults were acting up.
Oh, yeah.
So
oh, yeah.
That was fun.
That was great.
And what about you? How was your weekend?
It was really good. I did not go to German school yesterday or Saturday because I belong to this organization called Young Lives, where we mentor teen moms. And I've stated before that I was a teen mom. And so it's my mission and my passion to give back to these teen moms. But we took 20 girls from the Charlotte area to camp at Carolina Point. And it was so beautiful because these are underprivileged teenagers who have low self-esteem, which is, some of the things that we'll talk about today, or some insecurity issues. But these are girls that just need to feel loved. And so we took them to camp, and it was probably over 200 girls total at the camp at North and South Carolina, but we took 20 from Charlotte and their babies. So, these girls range from 14 to 18, and they brought their babies, and we had volunteers from all over the country to come and volunteer and babysit their babies just so they can be a teenager again, so they can go to group and learn about Jesus and zip line and do go-karts and do the things that they would normally never get to do. And so they were just loved on all weekend. And then at the end of the camp yesterday morning, it was almost like a spiritual ceremony where you can just kind of reflect on what happened over camp. And it's our opportunity, we call it say so, because the redeem of the Lord say so, that's one of the scriptures. And so we call it say so, and they can stand up and make the declaration to give their life to Christ. So you, I'm telling you, all the tears and
I'm
everything in
sure.
that
Oh
place, I
gosh.
was a mess, a
I'm
mess. So
sure.
it not only changed their lives, but it changed mine too. And just wanted me, just encouraged me to even support them even more. So that's what I did. And then I came home, took a little nap. Hubby was out of town too, so he went to my daughter's basketball game, and then we watched the game at home. Of course, we woke up in first quarter, so we watched the game at home. And I was rooting for the Eagles, so I'm glad that they won. And even though I'm a Steelers fan, but it was good. We had a great time.
Good. I love the fact that I mean, so many different ways to give back, but I love the fact that that organization allows the girls to just be kids. I
Yeah,
mean,
we forget that they're
there's so
kids. They're
many
still
different
kids.
aspects of, when you think of giving back, but that's something I haven't heard of before, so that's
No, yeah, and I
amazing.
was a little uncomfortable with it, to be honest, in the beginning, because I was like, when I was a teen mom and I had to grow up quickly. I had to grow up quickly. I mean, I took parenting classes. I, had to finish school early. I had to go to college early. I mean, I had an accelerated program. My life track was now accelerated because of that. And so, I was like, listen, but these girls don't have that opportunity. So they were able to be kids and be teenagers and just be able to go to camp. I mean, that was
If only
actually,
for a weekend,
yeah,
that's
even though,
wonderful.
yeah, they do it a full week in the summer. But these girls, I mean, they would never, that's like vacation to them. They would probably never have an opportunity to go to camp or any type of vacation in their current situation. So,
Amazing.
yeah, it was good. It was really good.
Amazing.
So again, so our topic today is how do we support the Leslie Joneses of the world? And we thought about this because of the tweet that she sent out, and I'll read it and quote her. She like in the in the in mid workout, Leslie Jones, she took a picture and she explained how she felt that her work was pointless. And she says, "Okay, back to cardio, but confession. I feel like I'm doing it for nothing," she wrote on Twitter. I feel like what's it all for? If the people you want to notice you don't. I just feel like I might die alone. Sorry, that's pretty heavy today." Quote. So end quote. So that was how, she was feeling at the moment. But as we think about all the clients that come to us that are broken, or, and not saying that she is, but that feeling goes through so many different people's minds. She's not the only one.
No,
Leslie, you are not the only one.
she is not
You
the
are
only
not.
one. And I think, and for those of you who don't know, she's a really famous comedian, and she's done a lot of things, Ghostbusters and a lot of
Saturday
different
Night Live. She's
Yeah,
an
she was
active
awesome
role.
at that.
Yes.
So, I mean, she's so talented, and people would probably look at her on the outside and say, "She's so talented. She's just, seems like that friendly person that I could have on my couch, and she can come in and we'll just have a good time together. She's accomplished, she's talented in her own right." But who knew? I mean, that she still struggles in that area of just, I mean, the basic everyday thoughts of being alone
that normal people have. I mean, she's a celebrity.
That doesn't surpass. I mean,
it doesn't
pass through anyone or pass over anyone.
No, it doesn't. And if you think about it, but she's dealt with and still dealing with all this cyber bullying about, you know, people just, you know, saying all these nasty and mean things about her, which, you know, we just pray about it and we wish that it would just stop, because you don't know what it's like to walk in that person's shoes. But here's the thing, like, nobody's exempt from it. And the more, you know, the more of a spotlight that you have on your life, the more visible you are to these cyber bullies, which is unfortunate.
Yeah. And I think it makes us more sensitive. I mean, I'm so happy that she is, you know, mentions it from time to time. I know, I think it was last year or the year before, I think it was last year, where she had the premiere for Ghostbusters, and she was even complaining then, or just, you know, airing out how her thoughts about how none of the designers would make a dress for her.
Oh my God.
And so finally, you know, this one designer came through and he tweeted her, and she took him up on his offer, and he made her this beautiful red dress, and it was, you know, kind of capturing the essence of Pretty Woman, the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And so, I mean, she looked gorgeous. I mean, she looked so pretty, and it seemed like she just felt like the belle of the ball. That was a big story then. So, I mean, she has been battling this for a while in a lot of different areas, and I think a lot of people can relate to it, mm-hmm. definitely.
Mm-hmm. They definitely can. And so I guess if we were giving tips to Leslie and whoever else is listening in the Leslie Joneses of the world, we would probably have you start with a daily mantra, you know, something that just will ensure you on a daily basis that you are worthy, you are enough, you are valuable, you are beautiful, you are intelligent. I mean, all of those things, what attribute describes you? So we want you to write that down and memorize it and recite it every day, even if it's a scripture. I mean, if we're going there, you know, you are beautifully and wonderfully made, you know, those types of things that will relate to you, even if it's an encouraging word or something like that, a quote or something like that. We want you to write it down and memorize it and say it every day. Memorize it, and even put it, you know, if you need to put a post-it note on your refrigerator, a post-it note in your bathroom while you're brushing your teeth. But we want you to recite it every single morning that you wake up, because we don't want you to forget it.
Mm-hmm. Yes, definitely. I think that's great. Definitely having something to encourage you that you can see every day. I would say also just thinking out of the box on what makes you attractive. So I was just thinking about, have you ever seen someone or met someone who was not attractive at all? And I'm not saying that Leslie isn't. She's a beautiful person, a beautiful human being. But have you ever seen someone that you're like, oh, you know, they're not, you know, Halle Berry, or, you know, they're not this model, but something about them just makes them super attractive. I don't know what it is. It might be their personality. It might be that they're warm and fuzzy. It might be they have a style to die for. It might be, you know, just whatever, their confidence. So, I mean, I think that in addition to outward looks, you know, our physical appearance, we put so much pressure on that. But, I mean, each one of us is blessed with so many gifts that we can think outside of the box. It doesn't have to be just, oh, do I have this pretty model face of what, you know, society says is beautiful. We all have other things that make us amazing.
And, you know, I agree. And I also agree that there's something physical on every single one of us
Definitely.
That we have that's beautiful. I mean, Leslie has beautiful skin.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, her coloring is just, you know, unbelievable. People stay on the sun all day trying to get some
color. Yeah, her smile is
yeah,
amazing,
it's gorgeous.
Too.
Mm-hmm. That's right. I mean, mm-hmm. her style. So those types of things. I mean, think about, you know, one of the things that may be, that may make you unique and maybe beautiful, like some physical characteristic about yourself. I would also say, you know, prepare for him. Take this time, the waiting period here that we have, and where we're waiting for someone to come along. But take this time to really do a self-evaluation on yourself. I mean, think about your schedule. Think about, is there room for him?
Mm-hmm.
Think about, are there things that you need to work on within yourself? I mean, maybe, you know, you're still harboring some past relationship issues that you have dealt with in the past that still give you pause or things like that, because we want this man to have a clean slate. And we talk about it all the time. Like, we want him to have a clean slate and a clean shot at earning your heart. So mm-hmm. he does not have anything to do with what Tim, John, and Jeremy did, you know, previously. He don't even know them. So we want him to have a chance with you. So whatever it is that you may be harboring and need to deal with, you know, we encourage you to deal with that. And it, perhaps it is, you know, your self-confidence or self-esteem, because we want you to go in this relationship confidently.
Right. Yeah. I would also say, you know, just think about what would it take for you to believe. You know, a lot of times, as coaches, we help our clients to dream. So everybody has a dream. And sometimes those dreams can be deferred or put into the back burner because, you know, for whatever reason, we just have heard so many times, oh, you'll never get married. Or, you know, we've just believed that at this point, you know, maybe I'm not attractive enough, or maybe I'm just don't, you know, have the girlfriend skills. Or if I go out to a club, or, you know, I go out with my girlfriends, nobody's ever looking at me. But what would it take for you to get from where you are right now to believing that I am someone's girlfriend? I am the person that someone out there is waiting for today. Mm-hmm. And I'm somebody's wife. So what would it take for you? And you can think about that and evaluate mm-hmm. what that answer is. So it might be, you know, I need to build my confidence. It might mean, you know, like Tana said, having some daily mantras around. But what is it between where you are today to where you want to be in that belief system?
Mm-hmm. And you know what? We call it your roadmap to a healthy relationship. We call it your blueprint. So we want you to establish what that looks like. You know, how are you going? You have the end result. The end result is that you want a man. Mm-hmm. Let's just keep
and
it
he
real.
Wants you. And he, how about yeah,
exactly.
That?
Wait, wait a minute.
Yes. There's a man out there that wants you. Yeah, so absolutely. Where are we between here and there?
And write down what that looks like. So, I mean, it could, you know, it, and then write down also, if you think about it, what type of, you know, wife do you want to be? You mm-hmm. know, what does that look like? I mean, so all of these things, there's a strategy behind all of it. And we, you know, we, you know, help our clients with it in coaching. But again, there's a strategy behind it. And so we call it your roadmap to a healthy relationship, and it's your blueprint. So you might start to, you know, do the architectural design of your blueprint.
Yes.
So we want you to start that today. Be clear about what you need from him. Be clear about what you need, and be clear about the type of man that you need. I mean, you know, we go over this in coaching all the time too. You know, it's interesting because we could be spending time with the wrong person, mm-hmm. spending time with the wrong person. So, you know, we can have this long laundry list of what we want. And just because he has a nice smile and he smells great and he's funny, but yet he doesn't share your same faith value, or he does not, you know, he's not supportive of your career or whatever it is, then you're spending time with the wrong person. So be crystal clear about, you know, the type of man that you need. And in his role in your life and how he can help you. And for Leslie and the other Leslies of the world that are powerful women, we need to also really uncover how he can help us. And mm-hmm. they want a job. You know, they want a job to do in your life. They need to feel needed. You know, what's his role? You know, how can he help you? And so think about that.
And I think that's great, because I think one of the challenges a lot of times with that is communicating that to everyone else. So let's say there's a great guy out there who, you know, because Leslie seems on the outside like she's very powerful, she's very strong, she's, you know, got everything going on. So he's probably thinking, what can I do to help her? So what she can do, and other Leslies out there, I think, first of all, evaluating your circle around you, your circle of influence, and then not being afraid to share with them, you know, I need someone who I can share my heart with, somebody I can trust. I need someone who, you know, is not going to be overwhelmed with my fame, or just someone who's loyal or trustworthy, someone who will have my back. And I mean, even just start sharing the things that you need, the types of characteristics. A lot of times it's so funny because we have clients and friends who will say, you know what, someone will always, you know, try to hook me up, or, you know, suggest some type of hookup with someone, and they have done absolutely no background. It's just, oh, you're single. Oh, meet my friend. They're single. But it's so such a waste of time, because they're like, we went out, it was like nowhere near what I needed. But that goes back to, you know, sharing what it is that you need, what type mm-hmm. of person you want, and how they can help you. And so that when your friends or when your circle of influence around you happens to come across someone, first of all, they'll know that you are looking. And secondly, they'll have some type of information, or you can steer them as mm-hmm. to what type of man would be good to introduce you to, and what type they need to keep on going
yeah,
from.
It's so funny.
Not just because they're single mm-hmm. with a pearly white smile.
You know, it's so funny, because then the other side of that is that, you know, we have these ready-made matchmakers that they say that they are. I mean, and friends, and so we'll say, you know, do you have anybody? Oh no, he's not your type. Well, how do you even know? They're always discounting somebody before,
yes.
you know, before you can even give them an opportunity to, without even uncovering what that is.
You know, that backfires. Yeah, so sometimes your friend is just too good, and it's
she's like
okay,
oh, no, she don't even know. Let me make that decision.
Yes, yes.
Don't negate them right off the bat.
Exactly. So give them some direction as to what type of person you're looking for, and maybe they were a dog back in the day, but we don't know
I mean,
if they're a dog
change.
Now. Yeah.
We are so different now. I mean, you think about it. We're all different from where we were in our 20s. Well, I would hope so anyway. Mm-hmm. I know I am.
Oh, yeah, I am you know? Too. I mean, hopefully there's some people out there that are listening in their 20s. So,
yes.
But yeah, mm-hmm. So, I mean, I think at each stage of dating, you're definitely, or in relationships, you're always different than you were
and it's
before.
It's a learning experience. And I need we need you all to be clear with what type of man you can command. Also,
oh, wow.
I mean, so
yeah, that's for all of us.
It is. It's for
that
everybody.
For
what type of
us.
Man can you command? Mm-hmm. So you know, you may want this long list of you know attributes in this gentleman, but then can you command it? What are you offering him? And
right.
so we talk about that also a lot. I'm dating USP, your unique selling proposition. What makes you different? So just as you're waiting for him during this waiting process and this waiting period, think about. You know, what are you offering him? What can he get from you that he can't get from anybody else?
Yeah. I mean, what have we seen so far? We don't know her personally, but
no.
what have we seen from Leslie that she can offer someone? First of
well,
all,
she can offer them some laughs.
Well,
that's
she can
what she
offer
can.
Them some laughs. Whether she wants to after five is a
I'm
different story
you.
Or after nine. When the lights go off, I'm not sure, but she can definitely
yes.
offer them some laughs.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, she just has an amazing personality. She has a great body.
Yeah.
I mean, let's put it out there. She is working out. But I mean, every time we've seen her out there, she has a beautiful physique. And I mean, she seems to be someone who's very positive. You know,
mm-hmm.
she seems to be a positive person and definitely very genuine. So all those things, when you start adding
mm-hmm.
them up, what kind of girlfriend would she be? What is she? What are the Leslies of the world?
Yeah.
What are you offering and what do you
mm-hmm.
have out there as far as, you know, what you're offering as a girlfriend?
And she's authentic too. I mean, she's put it out there already. She is, you know, I mean, if you think about it, how many times do we have coaching sessions with our clients and it's like peeling back an onion to get to their vulnerability? I mean, she, you know, she's putting it out there herself. I am afraid
right,
that I'll die alone,
mm-hmm.
you know, but here's a news flash, Leslie, we're all dying alone.
Well, this is true.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
This way,
we are.
We are all done alone.
Yeah,
and
but
so,
I think she's talking about someone by
is.
Her bedside.
Yeah, she
yes.
is by her bedside to
that
be
will
with
care.
Her.
And, yes. And so
we get it. And we think that, you know, as I was thinking about her this morning, about what type of man that she needs. And again, we don't know her personally.
Mm-hmm.
We don't, but just what, you know, but off the bat, you know, I can think about, you know, she needs someone that's secure because she has some vultures around her. She has some haters around her,
oh,
but
yeah.
she needs somebody that's confident and secure. Somebody that doesn't mind the spotlight because she has it. I mean, she's in the, you know, she's in the media all the time. Someone that doesn't mind her having the spotlight and he may take the back burner or he's very confident within himself.
Right. You
and know,
we don't need two Leslies either.
We don't.
So
no,
we don't need
no.
someone who
it's
wants
competing.
To be Leslie.
Who wants to be
also.
Leslie. No, we
do learned
not need
that early
that.
On.
We don't need anybody that wants to be Leslie.
No.
So someone who's very, very secure in himself. We also, you know, she probably also needs, you know, someone who's going to encourage her and maybe words of affirmation is their love language.
Oh,
you know,
yeah.
somebody that's going to say, baby, you are gorgeous. You are beautiful today. You are beautiful every day. And I support you. And you are all of that. She needs somebody that's going to encourage her when these cyber bullies and these vultures come after her. I mean, because it's not going away. And it doesn't even matter how you look. I mean, they go after the most beautiful women in the world. I mean,
yeah.
they're not exempt from this.
they're, no,
not.
They're not.
They're
no.
not. Mm-hmm. So she needs someone who, you know, probably their love language is words of affirmation, and that's how they show love.
Right.
And hopefully she receives it that way as well. And just, you know, to be able to just support her and encourage her in her career. Sure. So that's what I'm thinking, just off the top of my head, of the type of man.
Yeah, and I was thinking, even, I mean, she's, I'm sure, open to all different ethnicities, but I mean, there are many places, even in the country and the world, I mean, that would love all of her stats and her characteristics. Oh my gosh.
Girl, he may not be here.
He might not be right here. So, hey, open up your world. We found, you know, all types of men all over the country, all over the world.
Yes, we have.
So I'm sure she travels a lot too. And I think it was interesting because we traveled, we were speaking somewhere, I can't remember where it was, but we were on a panel and someone asked us, so they posed this question. So, you know, do beautiful people get more opportunities? And so I thought that was interesting. And there was some backlash also because when Leslie Jones posed this question, Megan Good came to her rescue. And some people were like, oh, come on, you know, Megan, thanks a lot. But, you know, you're beautiful. And, you know, and so, of course, it was still kind of like a downer because, you know, Megan couldn't even give her any advice because she has her book out with her husband, you know, The Weight. And she, you know, they're talking about relationships in their own right. And so I asked that question. I mean, do people, you know, who are deemed beautiful have more opportunity either in relationships or just overall? And so that was a really tough question. I thought that, you know, they asked us and I had to think about it. So I think a lot of times, yes, in society, they do have more opportunities. They have more opportunities to meet more, you know, singles. They have more opportunities for jobs and careers. I mean, it's just something that's unfortunate, but it's the truth. But I think, you know, going back to developing what God has placed in each of our lives, whether it's physical characteristics, whether it's internal, whether it's different things that, you know, you bring to the table and accelerating that whole package, I think everyone can kind of be on the same page. I mean, there are people who are successful, who are beautiful, but then there's other people who are successful too. And you're like, what on earth? Think of Kevin Hart. I think Kevin Hart is, you know, extremely attractive. Mm-hmm. But if he, you know, sat back and said, well, I'm very short. I can't make it with everyone else because I'm really short. But he has other things that, you know, make him attractive and made him, you know, along, of course, with his skill, but made him on the same playing field. And I think also he has a lot of confidence.
Mm-hmm. Absolutely. I mean, when you, you know, when you have when you're 5'4", 5'5", and as a man, you have to have a lot of confidence. And that confidence will make you 6 feet in about 2 hours.
Yes. Yeah, did you see that picture of him with Shaq? I mean, he even embraces it. He's like
up to his knees.
I'm down here. But guess what? We're in the same room. Okay. Right. But guess what? We're in the same room.
And we operate with the same green money.
Yes, we do. So sometimes, you know, those types of things can get us down. I mean, we all have things that, you know, can get us down that we don't have, you know, as much as somebody else. But I think it's all in how you handle it is what I'm saying.
Definitely.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So we want to thank you all for joining us and, you know, hope that this discussion, you know, jogged some your memory or just something resonated with you to help you move forward. But we want to encourage all the Leslie Joneses of the world, just first of all, thanking her for being so transparent.
Yes, because that's the first step in healing. It's hard.
It's the first step in healing. And just knowing that we surround her with love and I believe there's love out there.
Absolutely. He is there. And Leslie, he may not be in L.A., young lady.
He may not be in L.A.,
girl. Go out of the country, wherever you need to go. You know, he's going to find you because you are beautifully and wonderfully made.
Yes, she is in so many ways. And so are you.
Yes.
So we thank you so much for joining. We hope you have an amazing day. And for those of you who want to reach out to us, connect with us on Twitter or social media. Our website is thematchmakingduo.com and all of our social media is The Matchmaking Duo. So find us and say hello or give us a shout. And of course, join our Facebook community.
Yay, hey lovers.
So have an amazing day. Thanks for joining us.
See you next week.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Just had to love her.